Serving Townsville and North Queensland, this is 7 Local News.
Tonight, Home Alone horror, a young woman terrorised by a gang.
An elderly man bashed unconscious on a morning walk.
A young woman says she thought she was going to die when a gang terrorised her while she was home alone in West End. But police have denied allegations it took officers more than 40 minutes to respond to her desperate calls for help.
Katie Brennix moved to West End just 1 week ago, never dreaming she'd become a prisoner in her own home.
They were just screaming at me. They were saying, "We're going to kill you, let us in, we're going to kill you."
The 23-year-old says a group of six people loitering spotted her and started to approach. She locked herself inside, but to her horror, they began bashing down the door.
I literally thought, if they get into their house, they're going to kill me. They're going to bash me to death, because they were so angry and they were so full of alcohol.
Katie phoned for help as she cowered in the shower.
All I could hear on the phone is this people banging. Katie was in hysterics.
The victim's housemate arrived first, well before police.
The fact that my housemate was out at Dirigan and got here quicker than the police.
Katie's ordeal seemed like an eternity to her, but police dispute claims it took them 40 minutes to arrive.
From the time the phone call came in until we actually attended was 5 minutes.
By then, the gang had gone, leaving a mark on the neighbourhood.
Police say break and enters in Townsville are on the rise, with West End and Garbutt the city's most rife crime hotspots.
We certainly focus on where the incidents are occurring, so our break and enter patrols will certainly be focusing on that area both day and night.
But for Katie, the sleepless nights will continue until the culprits are caught.
I'm okay at daytime, but I'm terrified at night.
Angie Asimus, 7 News.
An 80-year-old grandfather has been brutally bashed during his early morning walk. A resident action group in Kirwan is appalled by the attack and wants to expand its patrols.
Keith Harvison doesn't remember the attack, but he has scratches over his body, two black eyes and gashes needing 10 stitches on either side of his head to prove it.
It don't feel nice, that's for sure. It feels terribly violated.
A very fit 80-year-old, the Condon pensioner walks 9 kilometres every day before dawn, but the grandfather was lucky to survive his last stroll in Rasmussen. He was attacked from behind after 3:30 a.m. Wednesday, knocked to the ground and kicked repeatedly.
I would think that the skull was inflicted by a boot.
Keith woke up, still on the ground, and stumbled home.
Looked in the mirror, jumped into the car and went up to the hospital.
He thinks his attackers were a gang of young people.
It's a sickening feeling to be reading that this is going on.
Mark Smith started a resident action group in nearby Kirwan to act as informants to police. Now he wants to cover surrounding areas.
The presence may move them out and get them off the streets.
5 people have been charged in the past week during increased police patrols in Kirwan as part of Operation Nocturne.
Police say extending their crackdown to other areas is a possibility.
If that concentration shifts, then the police operation will shift with it.
Keith now has a new exercise regime.
Police have warned frustrated Coolangatta residents not to take the law into their own hands to try and stop street violence in the suburb. Business owners have had enough and fear tourism will be affected if the attacks aren't stopped.
The main street of Coolangatta after dark, and the violence is scaring residents and visitors. 3.8 million people holiday in the beachside suburb every year. Gold Coast Tourism fears the street trouble is now jeopardising the area's reputation.
The thuggish actions of a simple few really does undermine the work of hundreds of Gold Coast tourism businesses.
A local action group says it's been left up to residents to try to stop the violence.
We had to take things in our own hands because we felt that, you know, we could see that nothing was being done.
That's not a very smart thing to say, and I'm disappointed that they feel that way.
Police claim officers on foot patrol respond to calls for help in under 60 seconds. The local Chamber of Commerce says that response time needs to be all year round, not just during holiday season.
They need more troops on the ground. Simple as that. They know it and we know it.
The Coolangatta Chamber of Commerce wants the owners of late night convenience stores and food outlets to take more responsibility and provide security guards. But one store owner says he did hire a guard, but it made the problem worse.
People from the clubs, the late night clubs, they used to come and they used to pick on the guards. So that used to result in more fights than ever before.
Business owners want the security camera network expanded to help guide officers to get to brawls quicker. On the Gold Coast, Darren Curtis, 7 News.
An 80-year-old man has been bashed on his pre-dawn walk in Townsville. Keith Harvison had started his daily 9-kilometre stroll when he was attacked and knocked out. The pensioner needed 10 stitches after being kicked in the head.
These fellas aren't usually brave in the daylight. And there are usually a pack of them. They seldom attack one-on-one.
Keith says he'll keep exercising but will start his walk a little later.